In this video, we're going to work some problems involving gradients and directional derivatives. So in our first problem, we are going to look at a function f of x, y equals 2x squared plus y cubed. And we're at a point 3, 2, and we want to move with unit speed in the direction of the vector 3, 4. And we want to ask how fast is the function changing. Now this is essentially a question of finding a directional derivative. So this is another way to put this is find the directional derivative in the u direction of f at the point 3, 2. Where what's u? Well, u is the unit vector pointing in the 3, 4 direction. So there are a few things we need to do here. The first thing we need to do is we need to figure out what is the gradient of f. The gradient of f, you have to take the partial with respect to x and the partial with respect to y. And the derivative with respect to x is just 4x. And the derivative with respect to y is 3y squared. And we're doing this at the point 3, 2. So at 3, 2, this is 12, 12. Convenient. The next thing is we need to figure out what is the unit vector in the 3, 4 direction. So our vector v was 3, 4. The length of v is the square root of 3 squared plus 4 squared. And that's just 5. So our unit vector is v divided by the length of v. And that's 3/5, 4/5. So now we can figure out our directional derivative. The directional derivative in the u direction of f is u dotted into the gradient of f, or if you prefer, that's v dotted into the gradient of f divided by the length of v. And, well, what's the dot product of 3/5, 4/5 with 12, 12? Well, 3/5 times 12 is 36/5. 4/5 times 12 is 48/5. You put it all together, and you get 84/5. And there's our answer. If we're starting at the point 3, 2, and we're moving with at unit speed in the direction of the vector 3, 4, then the rate of change of the function is 84/5. So our answer is 84/5. But that's not the entire question. The next question is, what direction should we go to increase the fastest? The direction you want to go to increase the fastest is always the direction of the gradient. And with the gradient, we already figured out was 12, 12. So if you head in the direction of 12, 12, in other words, if you head due northeast, head north as much as you head east, then you're going to increase the fastest. What direction should we go if we don't want to change at all? Well, then we want to go perpendicular to the gradient. Perpendicular to the gradient means in the direction of 1, negative 1, or negative 1, 1. If we head northwest or southeast, southeast or northwest, then we're going perpendicular to the gradient, which is pointing northeast, and we're not changing at all. And if somebody asks you what is the slope of the tangent line to the level to this level curve, that's the same question. If you go tangent to the level curve, then the function isn't changing at all. So you must be going in the direction of these vectors, which have slope negative 1. So that's it for these questions about directional derivatives. Now let's work a question about tangent planes. So let's suppose we have a surface z equals e to the xy squared minus 1, and we're working at the point 1, 1, 1, and we want to figure out what is the equation of the tangent plane? So this could also be written as z minus e to the xy squared minus 1 is equal to 0. Actually, let me write it this way. Minus e plus that equals 0. And we can call this whole thing f of xyz. And then if we take the gradient of that, well, you take the partial derivative of this with respect to x, which is y squared e to the xy squared minus 1. Partial derivative with respect to y, 2xy e to the xy squared minus 1. Partial derivative with respect to z, negative 1. If we evaluate this at 1, 1, 1, we get 1, 2, negative 1. So that gradient, just like on the previous problem, is perpendicular to the level surface. So we have our normal vector. This is our vector that's normal to the plane. So what's the equation of the plane? The equation of the plane is x plus 2y minus z equals some number. And how do we figure out what the number is? We just plug in 1, 1, 1. And that's the equation of the tangent plane.